So yesterday I identified a problem with the video descriptions that I have on many, if not most, of my YouTube videos, especially the earlier ones. And what the issue is, a lot of times I had articles that were giving more detail than I was giving in the videos, because I was trying to keep the videos as short as possible. And even doing that, most of the early videos especially were really long. Well, one of the ways that I did this was I linked over to articles or commentaries that I had done on the Freedom from Nicotine board. Well, it turns out that in the past several weeks, the Freedom from Nicotine board was hosted at one company, was merged or taken over, I'm not exactly sure what the dynamic was, by another company. Youku was the first company that was the site was operated off of, and now it's under a group called Tapitalk. And while they migrated everything over, there were problems that we have with that migration. One of them was that the way the original addresses were, it was to a www.ffn.com/ and then a reference to the exact string that I was trying to link to. Well, now it seems that if the www dot is in it, the link does not work. And all the videos' descriptions were a good percentage. I'm not exactly sure. I just copy and pasted the address down. Those video addresses now are dead links. Now, I want to point out that I'm going to fix them, but it's going to take me time. There's over 400 videos that I need to go in and fix them. And because I have a limitation in sitting right now, it's going to take me quite a while to do that. That's not even my biggest problem, because the links also were in the Freedom board itself. A lot of those articles that I had links in them, and I just went and looked, and I saw that I had, under two different names that I was logged in over the years, I had 42,000 posts in one and 6,000 in the other. So there's 48,000 posts that have these bad links. Not only bad links, but coding got messed up, where if we had a specific kind of font, then you would it would do it as an HTML code, and then the font would be a certain size. Well, now those don't work in many places, and literally what happens is all the coding is showing up. So in many ways, I think it makes many of these links almost useless, because trying to read the article with all this embedded coding, or sometimes fonts that are too small to read, and there's 50,000 of them, there's no way I'm ever going to get all of these fixed. So generally, I actually have, in a big sense, shut down that board for new members, because I think using it as is a sole mechanism for quitting when it is really in such a bad state is ridiculous at this point in time. And I'm going to attach a video into the description here that I did several days ago talking about why we're closing the membership at that site, you know, because of these technical problems we're experiencing. But for the YouTube channel, I just want to point out that if you are going and finding these dead links, you can get around it by taking out the www dot and just having the ffn .com/ followed by the extension. Though that will work, but I'm afraid that in many cases you're going to get a really messy looking article. So it's probably not the first choice of materials to follow. Over time, I will try to fix the YouTube channel as much as I can to redirect it to other places where I may have that similar information. And the links going to videos are fine. Those are going to just the YouTube channel. But I just wanted to do a heads up here of the problems that we're having, why that's happening, and why it's going to take me quite a while to fix that. We still have any of the materials that link over to whyquit.com, any of the materials that link over to YouTube, those are working fine and are really good resources. But as far as the ones linking to where you'll see Youku in the title, it's kind of a hit or miss. And I'm afraid in more cases it's a miss than a hit, of where it'll be something that the information in there is really good, but it's so difficult to see and so difficult to, you know, read through. It may not be worth the effort and time of going to those specific links. Okay, just want to do a heads up. This also explains why I have closed down the Freedom Group in a sense for new members. And again, if you want more information on that, go check the video that I'll attach into the video description here. That's titled Closing Membership at the Freedom from Nicotine Board. Okay, again, even if that one venue is basically gone, the other venues are up. And you know what? Even if all the venues were to go down, your quit would still stay strong and your quit would still stay secure as long as you continue to stick to a personal commitment to never take another puff.